This is the antidote, the evergreen, the bargain of the century, and it's mine. In a previous video, I was wearing my Junghans Max Bill, and one very observant viewer saw this. He asked me, can you review that watch someday? Well, of course I can, Mr. Co. There we go, the Junghans Max Bill. Not a lot of watches can say they're part of the permanent collection of the Museum of Modern Art in New York, but this one can. So it definitely is a design icon for not even €1,000. But is it any good as a watch? Well, I've been wearing it for years, so I'm very, very happy to share my experiences with you. The Max Bill collection consists of an automatic and handwound and even a solar-powered edition. There's also a chronograph that looks really, really good, but I'll save that for a later video. This particular watch without date is my own, and is most truthful to the original, albeit a bit larger. It was my first real watch, and I've been loving it ever since. And that's quite a miracle, because on first sight, it looks bleaker than a German trying to tell a joke. But this piece has something I'm always looking for in a watch: personality. So let me take you through the history of Junghans, which has a very underestimated heritage. The company was founded over 150 years ago in Schramberg, which, as you obviously know, is located in the German Black Forest. First they made clocks, but they've been incredibly innovative with anything that ticks. In 1907, they already start using radium to light up their dials, something Guido Panerai only would start doing years later. And in 1907, they made their first car clock, something Hoyer didn't do back then either. In 1949, they introduced this fantastic in-house chronograph with the amazing J88 movement. And in the 50s, they introduced a mini-Vox alarm watch, about the same time as Jaeger LeCoultre's more famous Memo Vox. They even became the third largest producer of chronometers in the world, just behind Omega and Rolex. And in 59, Junghans invited a Swiss artist called Max Bill to create a kitchen clock. And that became a design icon. Now, Mr. Bill wasn't just randomly plucked off the streets. He was educated at a famous Bauhaus school, and later he was one of the co-founders of the design school in Ulm. In 1961, he turned that kitchen clock into even better looking watches. And they tell a lot more than just the time. Mr. Bill honestly believed that a well-designed environment could actually improve someone's life. And therefore, designers had a moral responsibility to make existence a little better for everyone. And I loved that kind of thinking. This watch still embodies that humble attitude. For me, it has become the antidote to big money-screaming designs. Now, I don't want to become too lyrical about this, but I think, in fact, this watch is a reminder of the days where greed and vanity were still considered sins. The watch has a perfect 38mm case and a calf leather strap. So yeah, to say it's understated is a bit of an understatement. But even after all these years, I'm still daily surprised about the detailing. I mean, you must love these tiny luminous dots, or the faceted lugs. Mr. Bill even designed the topography with a legendary elegant fall, which, if you turn it around, turns into a design chair. But it wasn't Mr. Bill himself who came up with the idea that would give this case its signature slim shape. In fact, it was head of watch creation, Mr. Schiller. He suggested using the domed plexiglass in combination with a sloped dial and hands. And I'm still passionately in love with this perfectly tailored solution. And if you align all hands, the perfection just completes. True to original specs, the modern Junghans Max Bill uses the same plexiglass. Now, that was hyper-modern in the 50s, but nowadays it has a bit of a downside. It's quite vulnerable. And that is why Junghans now adds a protective Sikrolan coating. Still, it must be noted that plexiglass is a bit more vulnerable than, for example, sapphire glass. So be prepared to change the glass every, let's say, 10 years. Now, I've never really been bothered by any of this because it's very cheap repair, but I think it's honest to let you know. When it comes to overall quality, I can honestly say it's excellent. It has only stopped running once, and that was exactly by the time I jumped into a mosh pit. So there is some real consumer advice here. don't jump into a mosh pit with your watch. Technically, the watches are decently equipped. The original Max Bill watches had what we would nowadays call manufactured movements, called the J84. Unfortunately, those movements are a little bit outdated now, so Junghans obviously uses ETA movements. For the handwound version, that's the 2801, and the automatic has the 2824. And that's my only small objection to this watch, because even if you buy it without date, you will still get a hidden date. And I know, actually, Junghans doesn't want me to tell you this, but in their defense, they're not the only ones who pull this trick. And it works like this. The movement is delivered to them with a date, so instead of removing the date wheel, they just cover it up with the dial. But pull out the crown, and you will still feel the crown winder grab into the phantom date position. It's a minor flaw, and the only one really. But this is not a watch you're gonna buy for the mechanical prowess anyhow. And that is why I've brought a surprise. Because this brand new version is called the Mega Solar. And it is powered by the big ball of fire that lights us. What's more, the in-house developed movement is radio controlled, so it never needs adjustment. And it has a 3-year power reserve. So remember to step into the sun every 3 years. Now, this automatic changing of time is a really cool thing to see. Unfortunately, we couldn't film it today, but I do have a small video on my phone still. It's quite cracky, but let's take a look. Now, that's pure magic, isn't it? You also have several strap choices, and it has a lightweight titanium case. And on a leather strap, it only weighs 24 grams. So that is about as much as your soul. And the price? That's the best part. Both the mechanical watch and the solar watch are priced below 1,000 euros. And that brings us to the question that even a late Mr. Bill is dying to know. Is this watch cock or is it cool? Oh yes, that's the coolest score we've had so far, and fully deserved as well. Mr. Bill described his design like as timeless as possible without forgetting the time. And 60 years later, time has proven he didn't lie. A watch is so much more than a tool to tell the time. It's an expression of your taste and personality. And finally, I want to say something about that price. 990 euros. That might suggest they did some concessions in the quality, but that's definitely not the case. The quality is really good. This price rather reflects the philosophy of Mr. Bill. These timeless shapes are not for the lucky few. They're intended to enrich the lives of many. So unpretentious, yet so elegant. I honestly think this is one of the best buys I've ever done. So yeah, Mr. Co. And everyone else out there who's looking for an excellent everyday watch below 1,000 euros, this really is a great choice. Period.